Hello and welcome to another video from the Dishwatch Dude. This video is about a watch that is a little hard to describe. Do I have to call it a knockoff? Do I have to call it a tribute? Or do I have to call it something else? Probably you directly recognize the design. Of course, it's Panerai design. It has everything a Panerai has, the lock for the crown. It actually works nice. The watch, you can wind it. That works nice. It is, of course, an automatic movement. As you can see, it's slightly decorated. Probably just a sticker again, but it is decorated. It's a really cheap watch, 20 euros. That is actually a good value for money. As you can see, the crystal is also nice. It's hard legs. But as you can already see, it has issues. And then I don't mean the hour marks that you can see, that they are kind of broken up. But that's only the way you look at it from the glass. But as you probably can see, I will try to zoom it in. The crystal is coated, but I don't know how they do that in China, because the watch is of course made in China. But they do it not in a good way. Let's say it. Let's stay nice, because it's completely all over the place. It's not a nice eagle layer of whatever coating they use. It is it's spotty. It just don't look nice. I have to say, you don't see it all the time, because if you walk with the watch outside, you hardly see it. But if you just have the right angle and you check your watch for the time, often you just get annoyed. Well, I do, because of the coating that is actually looking like a mess. Lug size is 24 millimeters. It comes on a leather strap. Actually, a quite nice leather strap. For this watch, I did order a nice steel bracelet, and that actually makes the watch wear more comfortable. And I think it looks really good. But with a lot of things, that's personal. I always fool around with straps just till I found the right strap for the watch. And yeah, that takes a few trials and errors, but who cares? That is the fun part of collecting watches, I think. This watch is running nice. I have it a few weeks now, I think even a few months, and I don't wear it too often, but every now and then. And it actually, I set the time. As you can see, it doesn't have a date window, so it's easy. You set the time and you're done, and it is keeping time very nice. It works well in the watch winder. I think it's by the directional winding movement. No idea what kind of movement it is, because I don't even know too much about the brand. What I can find of it, it should even be, it has something to do with Holland. But I don't know what. I mean, Paula Rice should be the name, or a holding name or a brand name. I have no idea. But I found something on a Dutch website, in Dutch, about the brand, that it the brand was created to make luxury watches available for all kinds of people. And the first thing that I thought by reading that was, yeah, I think that is what all those Chinese knockoffs do. They make a Rolex available for everybody who pays 30 euros. Because you do have the looks, and from a few meters distance, it really looks like a real Rolex. So they already do that. So why this brand is doing more or less the same, and probably being pretty proud of it, I've I've no idea. The watch again is simply using all the good things that a Panerai has. It feels good, it has the right size, it's actually just maybe a compliment for the brand, because if something is good and you make a copy of it, I see it as a compliment. They are nice because they put polarized on the dial, not Panerai, or just leave a brand name completely away. It's not a watch that you buy to fool other people. I know a lot of people actually only want a watch if it has a brand name on it. Even they know it's fake. Those are probably the people that buy a watch to impress somebody else. I bought it because I was very curious. And a real Panerai is pretty expensive. And I think a Panerai is way overpriced and a little bit hyped, because it's not a watch that add anything to the brands that are already there. A lot of people buy them because they were used in the Italian army and probably a few other countries, but that's long ago and they are not used in the army at all anymore. Well, they are not supplied in the army. What you have now is some private company is giving you an army-like experience if you buy a very expensive Panerai watch. And yeah, there are certain kind of people who really like that, and they think they are a hero if they buy a watch like that. That's probably why the G-Shock watches, for example, are so popular. People buy a lot of them, and I think they are ugliest. I will not use that word, but those watches are pretty ugly and do a lot of things that you totally don't need. Yeah, but that's with a lot of watches. I mean, who needs a deep sea dweller? I mean, let's face it, I have one. It's a great watch. I really love it, but I absolutely don't need it, because taking a shower is going pretty well with this one too. So yeah, I always have a problem justifying very expensive watches, because you pay so much money for just a name and all the things around of it. I mean, the Rolex, they just keep the stock as low as possible just to make people wait, and they can almost ask anything, because a lot of people pay anything they ask for it, to own a Rolex, only to find out that if they have one, that they really could use the money for a lot of other things. Rolex is not that special. I mean, they make a lot of them, only most of them go in the gray circuit, and people buy them actually quite cheap, but not from a fancy ID. So yeah, I don't care where you buy a watch, as long as you're happy with it. And if you want to pay 60, 70,000 euros for a Rolex, just do it. Because you make a lot of people very happy, especially the people from Rolex. If you want to buy a fake watch, also just do it. But don't buy one to impress other people, because I think that is the stupidest thing you can do. Buying a fake one for yourself, how good and how much you pay for it, you always know it's a fake watch. So probably a watch like this, now I come to the point, is a good alternative, because it has the looks of a Panerai, but nobody tell you it is. Not on the dial, not on the back. It's just a tribute, and maybe I just answered my own question. What kind of watch is it? Maybe this is what you can call a tribute. It looks like the original, but it doesn't try to be the original. It doesn't sound that bad if I say it like this. Anyhow, for 20 euros, probably 21 euros by now, they are a little bit more expensive. Dollars, probably 25. You actually have a very nice watch. It can get some beating. It doesn't break directly. The dial of the crystal, you probably have to be careful with it. I have a little scratch on it already, but you can hardly see it. keep an eye on the coating, because that is something you probably cannot see before you buy the watch, because I never have seen watches like this in any store at all. You have to buy them online, so you can probably ask the seller if they can check the coating of this good, but I think for the money you pay for it, they don't even bother. And if you send it back, you probably just get another one with the same problem. So it's something you should know if you buy the watch. Or buy one from another brand, a little bit more expensive, because watches like this you can find all over the internet, all over AliExpress and all the other Chinese shops. Sometimes with the Panerai logo, other logos on it, but the design will always be the same. So if that's what makes the watch interesting for you, you can always find in the same price range something else. I thank you for watching, and if you like the channel, please subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and if you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. If you like watches at all, you can always follow me on the Instagram, DutchWatchDude, and you will see at least a few times a day an update on the Instagram. And on YouTube, I try to post a video from every watch that passes my desk, but it takes a lot of time and I cannot promise to do that, but I try to keep the channel active in the way that at least once a week a new video will appear. Thank you for watching, and see you around next time.